Hello, it's Erika Art here. Hello to everybody and hello from Slovenia again. So this time I decided to show you how I mixed my paints. I will use some different paints here and some acrylic emulsion. I will show you first my emulsion. So this is acrylic emulsion, see? And it's really watery. So sometimes I use this one, sometimes I use this one, see? Really watery. But today I will use this one. So I have to open it. It's really watery, and of course, because it's watery, and it is sometimes in two layer. Sometimes the Okay, sometimes it's just looks like water in on the surface, but it's not. You have to mix all these, see? And it looks like a milk. It looks really looks like a milk. And it's really watery, very liquid, so I don't need any water, see? See how liquid this is. It's really liquid. Today I will mix some paint with you, so you will see how I mix paints, because I got many requests from my subscribers and other people how they want to see how. Okay, no problem. I will do a video. Maybe it will be too long, because I will not do time lapse. I mix this, and I will just put in the smaller cup, because you know it's difficult from this big. I will just pour here in this cup some of this pouring medium. Okay, so we have here pouring medium, and first I will just I don't know, I will take this paint. This is my Mary acrylic paint, and I will mix this with you. Then I will use some Amsterdam paint, and I will also mix with you. Maybe this one too. Okay, so first this acrylic Okay, I have to tell you, I never measured my paint, never. When I start, I have some problems. Okay, but then you see, when you are doing this really a lot of times, then you know how to, okay, what's wrong? How to, what amount and how to mix and so on. So I will just use some this blue, very nice blue, really nice blue. Okay. We got such amount of paint, and no problem, because you know the consistency, it's sometimes different. It depends which technique I will use, but this time I will just show you maybe for I don't know flower deep how I use this. So each time when I mix my paint, I just add a small amount of pouring medium, not much, just a little amount of pouring medium, and just mix this, mixing. So this is a process who really takes time. I really don't mix a lot with you in the videos, because in that case the video will be too long. And I pour again a little pouring medium, this acryl emulsion, and mix again. So I believe you will find some acrylic emulsions in your countries. This is Slovenian product, I'm not sure, I don't know if they sell to other countries, really don't know. I just buy here in Slovenia. So see, just a little amount and mix and nothing else. The consistency when I mix and mix again, I will get the consistency of running honey or running yogurt, and that I want. But this is too thick, you know. But you have to add a small amount because it's easier to mix. And well, if you will pour a lot of pouring medium acrylic emulsions in the paint, then sometimes you can't maybe mix, or sometimes you will pour too much acryl emulsion. So it's better if you put only of small amounts and then mix again and again and again. So that's a process who really takes time. But it's really it's necessary to do this. So each time only small amount of this, and no water. I never add water, because this pouring medium is so liquid, and it's not necessary to use water. See, it's a little better now, but still too thick. And again. But it's nice. This blue is really nice. Nice paint. A little more. And when I'm doing this flower dips, I never use floetrol, never, just paints and my pouring medium, that's all. See, almost. Almost done. And that's the consistency I want. See? Maybe it will be better if I use this one. This one, it's... you can see maybe better. See, this is better, yes. It's just flow down. It's really nice. So, okay, this is was my Mary paint, acrylic. Now I will mix some yellow paints. Some yellow, also acrylic. It's Amsterdam, see? Amsterdam, a yellow light. I need a cup and one. The process is the same. I just use some paint. Here, take some paint from the this bottle. See? Just take some paint. And that's all. And then I Just add some pouring medium and mix and mix and mix. See? That I'm doing really lot of times. So I've learned how to mix and how much, and because measuring really doesn't work for me, but yes, if you want, you can measure, no problem. I just don't. But then in the next okay, this is yellow. The next thing I will mix here with you, my metallic white, and then I will show you how it's the easiest way to measure, because some of you really needs some help with measuring. Okay, it's too thick, this paint. Already too thick. Maybe a little more. A little more this pouring medium, and this will be just fine. This yellow. And of course, for different technique, it's different consistency, isn't it? Sorry, I speak in Slovenian language. Sorry. Yeah, in for different technique, different consistency. So maybe for dips and ring pour, a little thicker consistency. For Dutch pour, a little thinner consistency. So this is the consistency I just did. And as you saw, as you see, when I pour like down, that's here you see a little circles on the surface, and this surface just sank down, see, or maybe a little heel. That's my consistency. Okay, now I will just show you how to measure next thing. This time I will use this pearl medium from Vallejo. You have to do like that, because it's have to. And also I will mix with my pouring medium and my white. I have here a cup, but first I will take a little cup, and I will just see this a little cup. It's not big, it's a little, and I will just put here some line like that, and that will be our measuring pot. So on this line I will just pour, so you will see, maybe it's not, it's, you can see here, I will show you, I will just make like that, so you can see from the, from inside, in outside, and I will pour some white, my white paint, just a moment. So through this mark, I will just pour my white paint and a little more. And a little more. This is the way how you can measure. And a little more. If you want to really to be sure that is amount you want, just make some mark to the cup, and Then do like that, so the paint sits in the cup and just reach this black mark. So I will now put this in this cup, just out from cup, and pour into the bigger cup. See? Okay, but I still have here this black line, see, from the inside. So, and now I will take this pearl medium and I will pour pearl medium the same amount of white, because the ratio here is 1:1, see, and a little more. Okay, this is reached this black line, and now I will just pour here through my white. And I really want to use all in the cup, so okay, and we got here some white and some this pearl medium. I call that metallic white, I don't know why, but I just call that. So I have here a mixture of white, this Amsterdam white, titanium white, and pearl medium, and I will add some more pouring medium and just mix. So maybe I should use a bigger cup, because this is a little too small for such amount I marked on the cup, on the smaller cup. This is too thick, sorry. So, I hope you will try with acrylic emulsion, but I don't know in... I have many friends from United States, and they just couldn't find there, but I don't know, maybe not under that name, maybe there is another name, I don't know. But this is just acrylic emulsion here in Slovenia, someone called a binder, because we use this acrylic emulsion when we build houses. And we have different way of build houses, maybe than in other countries, I don't know. So we just use these acrylic emulsions for the walls. And that's many types of acrylic emulsions. So you can choose anyone and try if it goes well with your paints. Because sometimes these acrylic emulsions really don't like all the paint, but mostly yes. So see what nice mixture we got. See? You see these circles I told you, maybe in white it's better. See? That's just fine. Coincidence, maybe a little more this pouring medium, but it's really full cup now. We mixed a lot, and see, just mixing this paint, I don't know, I'm probably talking 15 minutes or maybe more, because I don't look on the video, but if I will mix all paints with you each time, that will be video very long, because I don't want to do time lapse. People not want to watch time lapse. They told me, really many people not to do that. I want to see each detail, so that's why I don't want to do time lapse. Okay, see, circles. Okay, and that's all. That is my way of mixturing paints, and I don't know, we just did this one, see, and some yellow, but this is metallic white, and I use this for many things, really. It's very nice, and has a nice effect. So what can I show you? I cannot do the video now because it with some painting now, because the video will be too long. So I can show you what one more my painting last one. This was made with this acrylic emulsions. So sometimes I mixed two or three of them together. Sometimes I used only one. It all depends. And you see, if I just layer here like that, this acrylic emulsion has how can I tell you, has some plastificator inside, because it's just looks like that. See. I just have no words in English, but I just want to show you how it look. It's not varnished yet. Here is still a little fresh, a little wet, but here is dry outside. And okay, that's a lot of amount of paint here, but never mind. It's really dried perfectly, as you see. And I just I showed in many videos my dried paintings and my varnished paintings. So that's one I did I don't know last time. So okay, or maybe I can show you which one. Well, I have this one. No, I don't have here really. Not in that one. Now this, I made this one too with acrylic emulsions, but here was only one emulsion. And I used some reflex paint. See, so and this is dry. This is dry now. So okay. Well, I hope you are satisfied now, because I did this video just to show you how and how much. So just put some paints in the cup and add some acrylic emulsions, or maybe when you use Floetrol, it's the same procedure. But just put some paints and then Floetrol. Some people use ratio 1:1, some I don't know 1:2, or it's really different. But it's maybe just the author, the artist's preference, I don't know, because I rarely use Floetrol. And then added some water and just mix, and that's all. But I only use acrylic emulsions. Really rarely, really rarely use Floetrol, but I have it here. So I have it. But the Floetrol has a different effect. Floetrol makes cells. And when I make flowers, I don't want such cells like Floetrol just do. But this is our European fluoretrol. It has different effect than fluoretrol from Australia. So it's different. Okay, I hope you enjoy this video. Thank you very much to watch me, to watch what I am doing here, this time without gloves, okay. And I'm really happy, so you are watching my channel and subscribing my channel, so just happy. And next time I will do a video for you again. So next time a video. Bye. Bye from me.